Hello, welcome to my channel and today's video. My name is Alora and I would love to share a story with you if you have some time to sit and listen. This story is not clickbait, it is not me being dramatic, it is me literally realizing I could have died. Before I get started, I want to say I just came on over here from Twitch, which I just recently made. If you are interested in following me on that, I will be doing more live streams, more so as like a Q&A session to answer things you might be curious about the Air Force. So if you are interested in talking to me about Air Force topics, that is the best place to do it because I will be doing live streams more casually as opposed to on here. I'm very like prim and proper. I mean, I try to be. And I have like a very specific message I want to say on my videos here. So if you go over to Twitch, follow me there on my username Eloragene, same as here, then we can have more of a relaxed conversation about whatever you might want to know. So that being said, let's get into this horror story, if you will. And I have video proof, so get ready for that. So let's rewind back to 2016. I just recently completed BMT. I went to my tech school in Baltimore, Maryland, and I was there about fall, I would say. So during this time, my man and I were going through a lot. So we ended up breaking up around November? Anyways. We were not together during this span between like November and then February. We were apart. No, it had to have been in October. Anyways, here I am in tech school in Baltimore, Maryland, and Thanksgiving rolls around. I am single. I do not have family coming to visit me, and I am hungry. I'm also very lonely, if you didn't catch that from the whole single and no family kind of situation. So I had been attending church and kind of knew some people, so did I have Thanksgiving with them? No, of course not. Why would I? No. What I did, rather, was what seemed like a great idea to me at the time. Go on Tinder, the dating app, make a profile, and in that profile, I put in my little description, I am not interested in anything other than free Thanksgiving food. I'll be your fake girlfriend if you need me to. I'll be a beard if you need me to, as long as I get a nice home-cooked meal. That's all I want. If you are still watching by this point in the video and thinking to yourself, wow, you're really dumb, I can't disagree with you because yeah. So I made my profile, whatever. I was kind of swiping here and there, but I was like, okay, I'm just gonna sort of see what I can get. And I end up swiping like 5 people, 10 people maybe. Not that many, because I'm not trying to, you know, I'm not trying to get a guy. I don't want a man. I just want food. So I matched with a couple people, and of course it's like the nasty ones that are like, you can't come over for Thanksgiving dinner, but you can come to my place the day after for leftovers and like all this kind of stuff. And I was like, who do you think I am, first of all, to think that I'm not good enough for the food but I'm good enough for the leftovers? Wow, hurtful. So of course I was like, no thank you, no thank you, no thank you. Literally, if your mom makes me food, that's all I want. I don't care about anything else. I'm not trying to get, you know, I just want food. So I come across this gentleman's profile. I truly don't remember his name right now, but I was looking through his profile, looking through his pictures, you know, evaluating if I was like, okay, is he taller than me? Is he at least good enough to look at? Is he semi-funny? Let's kind of put together the pieces here. So he was prior military in the Marines or something. And he had a photo of him in his uniform. I was like, okay, he looks snazzy. He looks good, you know, clean cut. It looks like he cares about his appearance. He looks funny because whatever he said in his bio was interesting enough for me to swipe, obviously. And I was like, you know what? He looks nice. He looks nice. So I swipe and, oh, it's a match. Wow. And he messages me first. I wish I still had my account. I've deleted my account long ago. He messages me first. Hey, were you serious about that whole food thing? Like, all you want is that? Like, will you really be my fake girlfriend? And I responded, I was like, yeah, of course. Like, that's, can't ask for more. All I really want to do is have some food. So if you want, like, I'll be your fake girlfriend. It's fine. He goes, okay, I thought that was kind of funny, but if you're serious, then sure. It's like, okay, great. Sounds good. So we end up talking here and there a little bit, and I wasn't, you know, invested in him. You know, I just kind of was like, oh, haha, yeah, I'm just going to respond because I have to continue this relationship before I come and just use you for food. So I end up being like, so who's cooking food? Like, is it going to be good food? He goes, yeah, I'm Italian. Like, my family cooks this great meal. We have a whole situation. Like, all the family comes. And I was like, all right, great. So it's adding up to me. He's got a big family. Wonderful. They're all going to get together. That's a good quality to me. There's going to be good food. Wonderful. Sounds great. And he seemed nice. So after talking for a little bit, we kind of made up this narrative about how we met, because then, you know, we'd have to speak about it when meeting his family for the first time. And I was like, okay, so do you want me to, like, meet you somewhere? How do you want to do this? He goes, oh, I can pick you up. So I was like, yeah, sure. And I agreed to that. Because he was prior military, he was able to get onto the base I was stationed at from my tech school. So I was like, wonderful. He'll come pick me up. It'll be great. I get ready. I look very cute, very presentable. Did my makeup, did my hair. I have on a nice outfit because I want to make a good impression on his family. He texts me, hey, I'm here. And I go out to the parking lot. And he tells me what kind of car he had, so I'm looking for this car. I see the car. It's a little beat up, you know, it's a little rusty. Okay, no problem. And then he gets out of the car. And he's wearing some really baggy jeans and an anime t-shirt. And his hair is not cut. His facial hair is not groomed. He looks a mess. He looks a mess. And I was like, really? I put in all of this for that? It's not all about appearances. I'm not here to be shallow. So I'm like, okay, maybe he's just really nice. Maybe he's funny, maybe he's nice. So I like go up and give him a hug. He doesn't smell that good. He smells a little dingy. His hair's a little oily. I'm like, it's fine. He was like, okay, well, we can go pick up my cousin on the way over to my family's house. And I was like, okay, great. That's good in my mind. We're gonna add more people to this party so that I'm not, like, alone with him. So we get in the car, and he puts in his GPS, his cousin's address, and it's an hour away. And in my head, I was like, oh, no. Okay, so we start this drive in his dirty car, and I'm like, oh, what kind of music do you want to listen to? I see he has an aux cord. And he's like, oh, really, anything. Like, I like country and rock, and I listen to K-pop and all this kind of stuff. So I was like, okay. Do you want to, like, take turns listening to music so I can, like, hear some of your music and you can hear some of my music and we can just kind of, like, chill and listen to each other's music? He's like, yeah, sure. So I was like, okay, cool. Like, that's nice. And he plugs in his phone, he starts playing music, and he starts playing K-pop. And I like K-pop. I don't have a problem with K-pop. But he ended up singing, like, to me. Like, the whole way. And insert clip here. Yes. So he was singing to me in Japanese or Korean or I'm really sorry, I don't remember what language it was, but he was singing to me the whole way. The whole way. So at this point I'm uncomfortable and I'm getting those weird chills. So we get to his cousin's place. We all head to his family's house, which was like another 30 or 45 minutes away. I was like, you've got to be kidding me. So we get there. And luckily, it was a real house. Okay, let me just put that out there. Luckily. And I told my family I was doing this. I didn't just like randomly do this. So I'm in there, I'm hugging everybody, you know. Even though I don't know this guy, I'm not gonna be weird. I'm gonna treat them like I would anybody else. So I'm in there hugging everybody. My best friend is Mexican-Italian, so I know how important like first impressions are and hugging people and not being standoffish and whatever. So I'm talking to everybody, introducing myself and telling them about myself. And of course the question pops up of like, oh, how do you guys know each other and how long have you been dating? And, you know, nah, nah, nah. And of course there's like the women who are like, oh wow, you're so beautiful, and I haven't seen, he hasn't had a girlfriend in da 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 many months. And I was like, oh, you don't say. So his family was wonderful. At this point, I feel kind of uncomfortable around him, and I do this thing where if I don't like somebody, if I feel uncomfortable about somebody, I will ignore them and give them very short answers if they talk to me and avoid eye contact. And it's a very awkward situation because I truly can't help it. It is just natural for me. I don't intentionally do that, but that's what I ended up doing. I started to notice. I was sitting next to him at the dinner table with the food on my plate, which was amazing. And we ended up sitting like at the kids' table. You know what I'm talking about. So I was like speaking to and joking with his other cousins because they were cool. They were fine. But he was sitting next to me and I just felt kind of weird. So I wasn't looking at him. I wasn't really talking to him. So we finished dinner. So we go out to the living room to start watching the football game or the parade, whatever it's on. So we're sitting on the couch and sit on one side of the couch. And he comes to follow me, you know, and he sits on like a foot away from me, the other side of the couch. It's a small couch. So I'm sitting there and I'm watching the TV on this side of me. And he's sitting on this side of me. I have my hands just laying next to my legs. I'm just chilling, you know. He starts to creep his hand closer to mine. So that he's holding my hand. So our hands are just kind of like this. Before I awkwardly was like, trying to pretend like he didn't just try to hold my hand. And then he says something to me in Japanese. And I was like, oh, I don't know what he said. So I go back to the TV and he goes, do you know what I just said? And I was like, no. He was like, it means can I kiss you in Japanese? And I was like, oh. I turn away from him. And this man had the nerve to be like, I didn't hear no. I turned around so fast. I said, no. I keep watching the TV. I was like, this man really just trained? Did that just happen? At this point, I was like, you know what? I had my food. I'm ready to go. So I was like, hey, I'm not feeling that great and I have to wake up early in the morning. Is it cool if you take me home? I was kind of like, Lord, please don't let him be weird. Please don't let him pull off to the side of the road and take out his aggression on me. Please, please, please. If you guys take one thing away from this video, if you ever go on a date with somebody, a blind date or like a Tinder date, drive yourself, please. Because if you need to drive away, if you need to leave, then you're able to do that. I just watched Desi's video about like her dating horror stories and she said the exact same thing. Please, drive yourself. By the time we get back, I could tell there was like tension in the air. So I was like, okay, well, thank you so much for driving me back and thank you for letting me like meet your family and I had a good time and whatever. And instead of him pulling up to where I lived, I took him like down the street. And in the middle of the street, I was like, okay, you can stop here, that's fine. Because I didn't want him to be able to park. I didn't want him to be able to stop the vehicle in order to do something. So he literally stops in the middle of the road, and I was like, thank you. I got out the car and I left. I didn't touch him, I didn't look at him, I didn't do anything to him because I just felt so weird. So I got out of the car, I went back in, and I think he ended up texting me the next day. Like, I don't even remember, but I know the title of this video is way more dramatic than the story was, but if you think about it, please, think about this. I got into a stranger's car when I had a weird vibe. I drove over an hour with him to I don't know where. I had no idea where we were going. I trusted the fact that he was going to take me to his family's house and not kill me, or not bring me back to his place and drug me or something. And I got back in the car with him after I denied his advances, which sometimes is the reason men rape women or kill women. And I know that's dramatic. Listen, I get it. But when you think about it like that, I did not make a good decision, okay? I deleted the app after that, so I was like, I'm done. I can't do this. That's my story about how much of a dumb little girl I was and so desperate for food that I was willing to risk my life. Wow. Thank you so much for watching, and if you're interested in seeing more of my day-to-day life, then you can follow me on Snapchat where I talk about what's going on at work or random things. I show my dog on there a lot. Or on Instagram. But that one's mostly my face and makeup that I like to do. So, either way, if you're interested in any of that, and the Twitch as well, it's all in the description box below, and that is all. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!